Today we are going to get a precise background blur effect on these irregular edges using Snapseed and Lightroom apps. In Snapseed app now, here we have the reds and greens as contrasting colors. I will increase the saturation overall to get more color contrast, which makes the next step easier. Now going to black and white filter, I'm going to choose the color red to make it complete white, with the other colors which are opposite in the color spectrum more dark. Now using curves, I'm going to darken the image, which makes the grayish colors move more towards black. To make the other parts other than the flower black, I'm going to first drag the top point of the RGB curve down to make the image completely black. Then go to the masking screen. Here with the effect hidden and brush value set at 100, brushing on the white spots other than the flower to make them completely black. Now I'm going to invert the colors by dragging the top and bottom points of the RGB curve to the adjacent corners, which makes the flower black and the rest white. I'm going to save this. We'll delete this layer. Going back to the white flower. Here I'm going to add the original image with double exposure and choose subtract mode, which adds the flower only on the white parts. Saving this again. With these two images saved, I'm going to revert back to the original image. Now with the healing tool, tapping on the areas of the flower and focused leaves at the bottom to completely remove them. This is needed to avoid the halo effect on the final look. Now with the lens blur tool, reducing the vignette strength and transition and making the radial filter small and moving it to a corner, increasing the blur strength to maximum. We'll copy the effect couple more times to make a smooth looking blur. To make the final result interesting, I'm going to darken the image a bit with curves. Then use curves again to brighten and add orangish tones by adding yellows and reds to the image. In masking screen, applying it around the right corner. Saving these two. Now I'm going to open the black flower over the white background image saved earlier as a separate edit. Then adding the blurred image saved on top of it using double exposure with subtract mode. Now adding the flower with black background with add mode. Next, adding the original image using double exposure and setting the opacity at 100. Now just need the masking work on the greens underneath the flower. Zoom in carefully to get the masking right. This should be more easier as the edges are not so rough. So we got this fine result. Now exporting this to Lightroom app for a bit of color grading. But first, in the detail menu, adding sharpening to make the foreground further pop. In color menu mix, tuning the green hues to make them pop. Adding more warmer tones to the highlights. Adding overall vibrance. More pop by increasing whites and reducing blacks. The final result. Hope you found these tips useful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.